to Sayyidina. We have a caller with us. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam, rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Mawlana Sahib, on the timing of the Salat, I'm not sure if it was last week's program, but it's one of the Mawlana programs. He's talking on the timing of the Salat. And he mentioned ayat number 114 from Surah Hud, and also ayat number 78 from Surah Bani Israel, saying that, you know, there are three timings of the Salat that are mentioned in the Quran. Can Mawlana also clarify, you know, like when we study Surah Taha, and in the ayah number 130, Allah says, Fasbir ala ma yaquluna
wasabbih bihamdi rabbika
qablatulu shamsi wa qabla ghurubiha wa min ana illayli fasabbih wa atrafan nahari la'allaka tarda. Can you explain this one as well? And also at the same time, when we study Malla Yahzur al-Faqih, there's a whole chapter in there, you know, panch namazun ke panch okaat mein wajib honne ke asbab. Can Mawlana clarify this, please? And we're very grateful if he can elaborate on this ayah number 130 from Surah Taha. Does it not also mention five prayer times in this Surah Taha ayah as well? And as far as the Surah Hud is concerned, was this ayah revealed before Shabbe Mi'raj? And when was Salat became compulsory? Can
Mawlana
also clarify on this one as well,
please? Okay, thank you very much. Wa
alaikum assalam. My respected brother, the timing of Salah in Quran came only in two verses. The verse which you quoted in Surah Taha does not have any link with our obligatory prayers. That is time of Tasbih. Allah says, wasabbih. Sabbih. While if you see the two ayats of Quran, which you have also mentioned, ayat number 78 in Bani Israel and ayat number 104 in Surah Hud, very clear Allah says, aqim as-salat. Aqim as-salat. Establish prayers. In Quran, aqim as-salat means establish prayers. That is the obligatory prayers. When Allah says, liduluk al-shams. Duluk al-shams means the midday, when the sun is in the mid of the sky. Ila ghasaq al-layl, the darkness of the night. Wa Quran al-fajr, Fajr time, because one of the names of Salah is Quran. In Quran, Allah calls Salah Quran. Why? Because there is no Salah without Quran. No Salah, leave aside Namaz al-Janaza, which is not real Salah. It is only Dua. That's why Namaz al-Janaza does not require even wudu. Wudu ke bighair. Without wuzu, you can pray namaz janaza. Even a person who is in janabat state can pray namaz janaza, because it is not a real namaz, it is just dua. There is no ruku' in it, no sujood in it, no Quranic verse in it. The real salah is the salah which is either obligatory, like daily prayers, morning, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, or recommended Nafila, Namaz Shab, and the prayers which we pray as recommended. The timing of Salah in Quran came only in two verses by Aqim al-Salat. In Surah Hud, wa Aqim al-Salat, and established prayers. Tarafay al-Nahar, وزلفا من الليل, in the beginning of the day, which is the morning, and the mid of the day, ظهر and عصر. وزلفا من الليل, and when the night starts. So the verse in Surah Taha is not for timing of Salah. That is only وسبح, وسبح سبح. In Quran comes to glorify Allah. إن لك في النهار سبحا طويلا. You have in the daytime long chance to glorify Allah. ومن الليل. See? So it is tasbih, not the obligatory prayer. Number two, you find the Prophet himself praying Dhuhr and Asr jointly, Maghrib and Isha jointly. And when people asked him, why do you join Dhuhr and Asr together, Maghrib and Isha together? He says, كي لا أشق على أمتي. I don't want to put any burden on my ummah. The Prophet is the messenger of the mercy. He knows that his ummah will be in different places, different parts, different situations. If the prayers timings are five strictly, without joining, it will definitely cause burden on many of the Muslim followers of Islam, Muslim Ummah. That's why the Prophet himself in Medina, without traveling, without any unusual situation, no rain, nothing, he did pray Dhuhr, then Asr. He did pray Maghrib and Isha, and this is in Sunni books and Shia books. In Sunni books and Shia books, and it remained. Ibn Abbas, the famous Muslim scholar who is being called Habrul Ummah, the scholar of the Muslim Ummah, he used to repeatedly pray Dhuhr and Asr together, Maghrib and Isha together, and he used to quote the Prophet doing it, and he said the Prophet did it كي لا يحرج أمته. The Prophet did not want to make it difficult for his ummah to pray their salah, so he made it open for them, optional for them to pray either separately or jointly. That is exactly what the followers of Ahlul Bayt practice. We join Dhuhr and Asr, but we also separate when we want to separate them. We join Maghrib and Isha, but we also separate them when we have some situation to separate, which means both are allowed. While those who don't follow Ahlul Bayt, they take it as strict. Dhuhr separate, then after long time, Asr, then Maghrib, then Isha. Is it practical? Nowadays here, in UK, in Europe, today is the time of Isha, today. Time of Isha namaz, according to our Sunni brothers, is 10:15 minimum. 10:15. Imagine the young people who need to go to bed for tomorrow, they have to get up early. How can they pray Namaz Isha 10:15 evening in the night? Is it easy? When the Prophet told us that you can pray Maghrib then Isha immediately. This is one of the examples to see how Islam brought the facilities to make people worship Allah without hardships. But some people created hardships for themselves and for those who follow them.
Thank you, Maulana. Let's move.